Hello, I'm Fabien Zoulim from Lyon University, and today we'll cover the topic on the implementation of HBV cure, and we will see whether a cure for HBV is possible in the near future. As you know, the current drugs, nucleoside analogs, inhibit viral replication in the infected hepatocytes, but are not able to eliminate the viral mini chromosome, the cccc DNA, which is a form of persistence of the virus. Now there are new drugs that are emerging. They are direct acting antivirals that are controlling viral replication in a much more efficient way than nucleoside analogs, which act either before the cccc DNA formation or after cccc DNA formation. So these drugs that are at the pre and post cccc DNA targets are currently in clinical trial evaluation and mainly in phase two studies. Besides these drugs, there are other drugs that are trying to target the pool of cccc DNA directly to cure the infected hepatocytes. So these new approaches are mainly at the stage of preclinical evaluation. So besides these direct acting antivirals, we have strategies to boost the immune responses against the infected cells that are mainly relying on two categories, the innate immunity boosters, as well as the stimulation of adaptive immunity with the aim of eliminating the infected hepatocytes and or neutralizing the remaining virus that is circulating in the circulation of patients. So with this very active research field, we have now new drugs that are in clinical development, which is very exciting. And at the stage of clinical research, we have now the question of how to combine all these different drugs to increase the rate of functional cure. And this drug can be classified as inhibitors of viral replication, entry inhibitors, inhibitors of viral polymerase, including nucleoside analogs, but also novel drugs, novel nukes, as well as RNase H inhibitors and nucleocapsid assembly modulators. The second category of direct acting antivirals is drugs that reduce viral antigen expression at the level of viral transcription, or directly targeting viral RNAs with siRNA and antisense oligonucleotides, and drugs that target HBs antigen release, such as nucleic acid polymers. Besides these direct acting antivirals, we have strategies to stimulate the immune responses, either by invigorating immune responses, by stimulating innate immunity, especially with TLR8 agonists, or by blocking immune checkpoints. And besides these strategies, there are strategies to specifically stimulate the HBV-specific B or T cells with therapeutic vaccine, as well as new drugs such as exogenous monoclonal antibodies against HBs antigen to decrease the circulating HBs antigen and neutralize the virus. So now the main question asked by clinicians is, how are we going to combine these different mode of actions to increase the rate of clinical cure? And you see here just a summary slide to show you what are the main questions to achieve higher rates of functional cure, so HBs antigen loss with a finite duration treatment, either by combining direct acting antivirals, very potent drugs to inhibit viral replication and reduce viral antigen, to see whether this will be sufficient to decrease the pool of cccc DNA and achieve HBs loss, or whether we will need additional strategies to invigorate immune responses and immune stimulation on the top of a profound inhibition of viral replication to achieve a significant rate of functional cure. So all these type of strategies with different one or the other drugs are currently in phase two clinical trials, and we are seeing very promising results in that direction. So to conclude, the HBV treatment research field is very active. As I told you, there are ongoing phase two clinical trials with promising agents, especially direct acting antivirals. There are also combinations of DAs and immunotherapy in phase two. And we have seen first promising results with siRNA, antisense oligonucleotides, nucleic acid polymers, and checkpoint inhibitors, which allowed to show a significant decline in HBs antigen level and significant rates of functional cure in phase two. So now we are eager to see the first phase three clinical trials, and we hope that some of them will start in 2023. And the pipeline is very dynamic, as there are new drugs also entering phase 1b, and this will feed the clinical research development as well. So as a take-home message, there is really hope on the horizon, and the HBV community should remain engaged in the development of new treatments. Thank you for your attention.